Hello and welcome back to Igor Katlakin's fighter pilot career in the Battle of Kuban. It's now the third stage of this battle. It's called the second attempt. And Igor has been promoted to senior lieutenant. The latest newspaper have been delivered, so with his morning glass of vodka, Igor reads that the Red Army attacks heavily in the Caucasus. The Soviet drive on large scale breaks Kuban line, the defensive line that the Germans have set up along the Kuban River. U.S. Corsair held superior to Japanese Zero. Very, very nerdy military details on the front page of this edition. And as you can see, Igor Katlakin is proud top Soviet ace. Still. We continue. And Igor has transferred to Navy Air Force unit located at Galensik. And he flew his first mission last time. This unit also has the Yak-7B, which I only tried out, I think, two times in multiplayer. And we shall see how Igor handles that plane. Nothing happening this day. I'm hoping for another bomber intercept mission. I did one of those, it was pretty fun. 26 degrees, it's now the 27th of May. So Igor has been at it for more than a month. And to his own surprise, he's still alive. Now, two missions, but Igor is not scheduled for any of them. I think in general this campaign, the career mode it's very good. Although I would like to have a little more different types of missions. Gets a bit repetitive after 20 missions, even though, and I think the developers are planning to increase the amount of different kinds. Also, what I think they should add is different approach altitude for bomber flights, because they all go at 2,000 meters, no more or less. Intercept ground attack planes. This is the first mission of this type that I've been assigned to, and I'm gonna fly the Yak-7B. So it will be interesting. What I know from the Yak-B is a 7B. Compared to the Yak-1B, it should be a bit slower, a bit less maneuverable, has not as good view from the cockpit because it has no bubble canopy. It was developed as a trainer fighter for the Aquan series, but it ended up being more a better plane basically, so they decided to mass produce it for the war effort. And it has better armament. Two 12.7 mm machine guns instead of just one in the Yak-1B. So we are intercepting ground attack planes. Our number two, very short flight and on friendly territory, so I'm happy. Let's see, we don't need 100% fuel unless we are going to pursue them, but I think I'll go with 70. The compass, don't need that. No bombs. So we go straight to this position here and try to locate the ground attackers. I hope it's the ducks, because they don't have rear gunners, the HS-129s. Okay, the cockpit looks quite a bit different than the Yak-1B. I have to see where all the dials are. I'm sure I'll manage. Don't seem to be any Focke-wulfs left. Maybe they are returning back home. Okay, well, we've chased them away. It's time to land. Seems to heat up pretty easily. Temperature, water temperature was a bit over 100, and also the oil. Even though I had a full radiators open, but I have to say that firepower was really great. Maybe it was coincidence, but I set the Focke-wulf on fire, just short burst with the two machine guns and no cannon. So, yeah, I'm impressed. The view to the back is much worse than the Yak-1D, and it's definitely heavier and slower, but on the other hand it's very stable, I think. Yeah, I like it. See if I can land it now. Also notice that it has a manual tailwheel lock, unlike the Aquan B that unlocks when you hit a certain amount with the rudder. So yeah, that went good. See how the others fared. I think I shot down two. No, three. Excellent. I had lots of ammo left. At least I felt like it. Medal for Courage. Order of the Red Banner. Second awarding. Nice. I wonder if that was a flight of just Fokker Wolfs with some carrying bombs and some acting as fighter cover, but I think I only saw Fokker Wolfs. Oh, we got six planes together. Very good. Nice job, Filat and Konstantin. And I'm sure Matvei also did a great job covering us. Well, it was a fun first flight with the Yak-7B. Hope you enjoyed it and see you in the next mission.